In a world where consumers just don't seem to go out as much as they used to, any new player that has people lining up out the door for food or coffee deserves our attention. For example, look at Bluestone Lane. That's the privately held chain of cafes and coffee shops that's built up a huge following in the New York area. These guys take their inspiration from the coffee culture in Melbourne, Australia. Apparently, Australia's in, and the locations have become wildly popular. 11 coffee shops, 7 cafes, more extensive food offers, mostly in and around New York, but also there's one near my own hometown, King of Prussia, right outside of Philadelphia. And they're opening another in San Francisco. Now, look, we know the story's early, very early. But on any given Sunday morning, you can expect to wait upwards of an hour at a Bluestone Lane Cafe. What are these guys doing right? Let's check in with Nick Stone, the founder and CEO of Bluestone Lane, learn more about his company and the broader industry. Mr. Stone, welcome to Mad Money. Thank good to see you, sir. Have a seat. Have a seat. Okay. When I first heard about it, I said, this is the most crowded market in the world. We got Starbucks, we got Peace, we got McDonald's. What makes you think you can make a go here?
Well, I think coffee is very segmented, actually, and it's undertaking a huge change, driven by really the success of Starbucks. So Starbucks has done such a great job with commercializing espresso, and particularly with young people, the millennials, and they're looking for a more immersive experience, and they're looking for healthy food options, they're looking for a better type of environment, and ultimately better service. And that's where we've tried to take from the Melbourne influence of premium specialty coffee and bring it here.
Now, how do you get your name around? I mean, look, I don't want to say that you're a little guy because you're a tall guy, but you have powerful competitors. And yet, I have to tell you, I brought a bag in and everybody knew you. How did you get your brand so big in such a short time?
Well, really, it's through authentic engagement. We've never spent a dollar on marketing or
You've
PR.
Never spent a dollar on marketing?
No, you don't need to in this market. Because ultimately, if your customer demographic like ours is a millennial customer, they're probably very attuned to using social media.
Right.
And if you produce a great experience, then they will more often than not tell their friends and they will broadcast via social media.
Now, at one point, Howard Schultz, and he's always called it the third place, there's another place to go. Are people sitting at your places reading? What are they doing? Are they moving in and out? How do you get the flow?
Well, really, this stems back to why I created the company.
Okay.
It was part of my own daily ritual and twice-a-day escape from working in banking. And I think people just want a 7 to 10 minute escape, a little chance to go to an oasis to refresh and recharge. And I think in this world where we're seeing continued automation and efficiency, I think people like a little dabble of human connection for that 7 to 10 minutes a day, a refresh, and then get back to it. And it was really out of self-necessity that we created the brand. And I think that's continuing.
How big can you be?
Well, Starbucks has over 25,000 stores,
well, I mean,
right?
They've got this roastery concept. Will you always be boutique is what I'm asking, or can you blow this out?
Well, it just depends. Boutique could still be 5,000 stores globally,
jeez,
right? So if you're looking at Starbucks, they're investing in their reserve brand. They've stated that they want 1,000 stores within the next, I think, four years. So I think that we could be at that level comfortably within the next 10 years. Hopefully we can do it faster, but it is very challenging if you have a premium value proposition.
Right.
How do you maintain that experience at scale? But we've been quite successful in our first 4 years.
Where do you find your workers? I mean, because one of the things that people have been saying to me, this is the beginning of the tightness of the economy. Where do you find these people?
Well, there's a huge amount of artisanship, really, and people are fascinated about the subculture of premium coffee.
Are you getting people from Starbucks?
Yes, absolutely.
You are.
We are. Because we offer a more tailored experience and people want to move away from full automation to really being able to have a manual element.
Okay.
And they can be more precise and they can provide and have broader product proposition. They can they can play with the tools more than they can at Starbucks. And I think they also like working in different types of environments.
But I know from my restaurant, there's not as much foot traffic as it used to be. But how long are people waiting in some of your
restaurants? Well, I think coffee's the contrarian to all of the movement in the restaurant business. Because I think people are after the human connection. They may not want to be there for an hour, but part of the daily ritual, they love seeing other people, they love healthy food.
Right.
That's a huge movement that we've been focusing on. And I think that we're seeing, if anything, just increased traffic. And to be honest, the queues for the cafes is really because they want to catch up with their friends. Coffee's a very social medium. And in Australia, and particularly in Melbourne, getting coffee is where most of business dealings are done, catch ups with friends, family, time for yourself, and we're capitalising that.
Last question. A lot of these big companies watch the show. If they watch Nick Stone, is Bluestone Lane for sale?
I don't think it's for sale right now. We're very early on. We've only just passed our four-year milestone, and I've only been full-time for just under a year and a half. So I think there's tremendous opportunity. But, you know, who knows? In 5 to 10 years, we do want to scale quite expeditiously. We do want to scale overseas. So I do think there's a great opportunity for partners to help us. And we're very young at the caper, trying our best. So who knows?
I don't know. I wish you luck. I think this is terrific.
Thanks,
I really wish you luck.
Thank you.
That's Nick Stone, founder and CEO of Bluestone Lane. I don't know. I'm quite taken. I really interesting. Mad Money's back after the break. Booyah! Jim Cramer here from Mad Money. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube. Click here to subscribe and get the jump on my exclusives with CEOs, plus market news, investing advice, and a whole lot more.